Meow. Well, I think we should just begin, so we can get as many people as possible.
我觉得我们现在可以开始了，如果现在开始的话，每个学生可以多谈一些。
If I'm supposed to help you, then it's not good for me to just talk.
如果你们想让我帮助你们提高方式上面的技巧问题，还有情感问题，我觉得我不应该现在说的太多。
I can hear you play, and so does everybody else who wants to hear you play.
如果这样的话，我是希望你们，我要听到你们弹琴的状态，我才可以帮助你们。
Are you her teacher? Are you her teacher?
Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you.
Very well prepared.
准备得非常充分.
It's not quite in the Mozart style.
不是, 莫扎特, 不是非常符合莫扎特的风格.
I remember that we talked about the different periods of music.
我还记得我们讲过了音乐的不同时期.
The Baroque, the classical, the romantic.
巴洛克古典主义还有浪漫主义.
And the classical period Mozart requires a certain balance of sound and clarity and touch and articulation
for a lot of work. 充满了非常清晰度，有清晰度。
Articulation. Clear sound.
非常清晰的.
And a balance of the voices, the different notes, a balance.
对音符声音的一种平衡.
That is not heavy and leans toward the soprano, the top voice.
不是非常的沉重的那种音，是高音轻巧的高音。
Mozart was a lyrical composer.
莫扎特是一个像非常优美的一个作曲家，他的曲子都非常的脍炙人口。
And he was influenced in his development, growing up and so forth, by Italian opera.
他的成长，他的曲子都是受意大利歌剧的影响。
So the right hand is always singing.
所以右手的部分总是像在唱歌，在歌唱。
Like a singer in opera.
像在一个歌剧里面唱歌的那个人。
You have to be careful that the left hand and that part of the right hand does not have the note.
你要注意的是左手.
You have to be careful. Let's say the melody is in this part of the hand.
所以你要注意它的这个曲子旋律是在右手的这三指上.
And the rest of that part of the hand and the left hand is accompaniment.
然后左右手的拇指和这个第二指和左手这七个指头是伴奏。
So in order for it to be vocal, that part of the hand has to sing out. Well, the melody has to sing out.
你想让这个右手这三个音的旋律出来的话。
And the accompaniment has to be very subordinate.
左手伴奏和这两个手指伴奏的部分就要褪色。
In your case,
你的情况是,
you need to exaggerate that more.
你要把这种对比更夸张地表现出来。
The secondary or subsidiary material,
次要的事情是,
are in many cases or often.
大多数情况下是这样。
As loud as the singer.
大多数情况是像一个歌唱家一样，唱得非常响。
That's better. But
好多了。 但
I must apologize. Well, apology is not really the right word.
我想跟大家说声抱歉，但是抱歉可能不是正确我想说的这个词。
I keep finding in these students.
我在这个学生当中一直在寻找。
So much.
我一直发现大家都用了太多的胳膊的力量。
And high fingers.
然后很多高抬指。
Preparing for a note.
高抬指抬这么高，然后再去准备弹那个音。
It doesn't make any sense.
我不理解，这完全。对我来说，我不理解。
So he starts the very first note, da do, he did very good sound, da di da, but then he goes da 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 di da da da.
一开始弹得非常好，但是后来你又用到胳膊之后，声音就变了。肩膀这个地方，他在给你演示。全靠指尖接到那个键盘的琴键上。不要用到手臂的力量，只要把手指贴到琴键上就可以了。很简单，然后安静的。刚才那个音太重了。
Contraction。
你不用收缩你手指的肌肉。
Samurai, Japanese, Samurai.
像日本军队一样。你感受到他指尖的力量了吗？
No muscle, just
不要用肌肉
wait,
不要用太多的肌肉
more quiet.
我想听到
even more there.
我想听到比刚才弹的还要
when you started to play mi fa mi.
我想听到比刚才弹的还要安静一点的感觉
mi fa mi fa fa. He started mi fa mi fa fa. How much distance?
还是高抬指的问题。
How much distance between the tip of the finger and the key?
如果你高抬指的话，是有这样这么长的距离，你怎么来准备下一个音
？And it's soft.
而且这个这一段是要弹得很轻柔的。
Don't need all that.
你根本就不需要这样。
Right. Keep on the surface. Keep on the surface of the key.
你根本就不需要高抬指，你只要把手指放在琴键上。琴键的表面上。在表面上，把手指放在琴键表面上。
Sometimes,
有时候
when you train,
当你练习的时候
your fingers,
练习你的手指
to be strong and independent,
练习你的手指，让你的手指更有力和更独立
you need to raise them a quarter of an inch off the key, maybe.
你可能要这样弹高抬指
as an exercise.
但这只是一个练习
but there's not much.You know, occasionally in Italian word martellato, in certain passages, like a machine gun.
但在乐曲中很少有需要你高抬指的时候。
You need higher fingers, you know, for strength and articulation.
非常少有这种情况，这只是一种练习。
Almost never in Mozart.
几乎在莫扎特的曲子里面，从来没有需要你高抬指的时候。
Almost never in Chopin.
对肖邦的曲子也是一样，从来也没有需要你高抬指。
Sometimes in Beethoven.
有时候在贝多芬的曲子里面不需要高抬指。
But that's because he's Beethoven.
因为他是贝多芬。
Did you ever have, did you ever see a picture of Beethoven?
大家都见过贝多芬的照片吗？
见过，见过。
Let's do the first variation then, please.
弹的跟你第一次弹的完全不一样。
And only because, well, first of all, he's musical, he's talented.
声音完全不一样。首先是因为你非常的有才能。
But secondly, it's because physically he adjusted his position on the hand.
第二点原因就是。第二点原因就是你现在的手指贴到那个琴键的表面，而不是用你的胳膊。
And he has more control of the key.
然后你的手指指尖就有更多的控制力，控制这个琴键。
When you raise your finger very high above the key.
当你把手指抬得很高的时候
，the hammer hits faster the string.
那个后面的琴锤就。敲得很快
And sometimes it's ugly sound.
有时候是很不悦耳的声音
We call it percussive.
Percussive, 很不悦耳的声音
Metallic, yeah. Very good, very good, very good. Now,
非常好
I wouldn't use so much pedal.
这个地方他刚才弹的这个地方踏板不要用太多，如果是他的话。
You know, Mozart had a piano.
大家知道莫扎特有一个钢琴。
He did not write for the harpsichord. Harpsichord? You don't know what a harpsichord is? Okay. Well, we'll skip that. Beethoven had a, Mozart had an early piano, one of the early pianos.
莫扎特他是有一个古钢琴。
Had a very light silvery sound.
是古钢琴的声音非常的轻。
This modern piano with the iron frame.
这种现代的钢琴是铁钢铁的这种结构。
Has a very thick, muddy orchestral sound.
声音就很厚，有的时候会很浑浊。
In the bass.
在。低音的这个
So if you use pedal in the bass like he did,
如果像你这样弹用踏板的话
，It's not the right sound.
不是这就不是莫扎特声音。
Pulse, remember the heartbeat stays.
就像心脏一样。
gets faster, gets slower, but it's
心脏跳动，it
preserves its foundational beat.
心脏的跳动是围绕着一个基础的跳动的频率来的。
再次掌声感谢大师的精彩讲授。